Hello everyone, how's it going? Welcome back to Adobe Live and welcome to today's Adobe Express Masterclass. If we're just meeting, my name is Katrina Torrijos and I am the Adobe Express Evangelist and I'm also a content creator and streamer on the side. I'm so excited to be here today, so I just want to send a quick shout out to chat. Hi Cody, hi Umacorn. Who else? Hi Solani, welcome to the stream. Okay, I'm so excited because I am actually going to be teaching a class about video in Adobe Express today. And fun fact, I actually started off in my creative journey as a video editor. So I'm so glad to get back to my roots for a little bit and see how much I know, because I did leave the video realm and traded up for design for a hot minute. So let's see how well this goes. Hi, Oliver. Welcome to the stream. Okay, so let's just go ahead and get right into it. Here is Adobe Express. Oh my gosh. Please, notifications. So if you're unfamiliar with Adobe Express, so this is the beta version you can get here by going to adobe.com/express or new.express.adobe.com. It is completely free to use the beta and try it out. And today we are going to be using the video features. So this is the homepage and we're actually going to start from scratch today. But if you're just getting started in video, you can browse the templates. So let's just go ahead and really quick look at a couple of the templates. So they have like fun little stickers and layouts and text already here. So if you just wanted to plug and play into any of these video templates, you totally can. But yeah, so it pretty much just bumped us into the editor. And like we have a blank page right here. We have a timeline down here. So for those of you who have not played around with the video features yet, I'll do a quick little rundown of what's going on here and like how to get started and stuff. So again, of course, you can use one of the templates, but let's just close off this menu really quick. So we have this timeline down here, and it basically shows like different scenes. So that's like different. I look at it as pages in a way, and you're kind of building out your timeline, and on each scene you can add in a different piece of footage. So let's go into media. Maybe let's add in like one of these stock videos. So let's just go ahead and drag it in. And then now it's added to the current scene. And then when you click on the footage itself, you do get a couple different options. Like you can mute the clip if you want. You can adjust the speed ramping so you can make it faster. You can give it like a bit of a slow-mo kind of effect, like such. And then this is what it looks like really fast. So it speeds up the clip. You can adjust the opacity. And then there's blend modes. You can even fill the video here so that it just snaps to the background. And what else can you do? You can also add in some effects like the, what's it called? The duotone filter. You can also adjust the footage as well, like adjust the contrast, brightness, and do some light color grading. Let's reset this, and then you can also add in some animation. So if you want it to go in, this is kind of how you do it. So yeah, you can add animations to your footage as well. Okay, so let's just go ahead and get started. So today we're going to be making aesthetic vlogs specifically for TikTok and Reels today. So if you've ever been on TikTok or Reels, you'll see the aesthetic vlogs of like the day in my life or like a travel diary or even something random. So today we're going to try and recreate that effect. So if you ever wanted to make fun, you know, Reels that look, or TikToks that look really aesthetic, really good, maybe moody, depending on what your aesthetic is, really, then, yeah, keep on watching. Okay, so we're going to start off with adding in our clips. So recently, I went on vacation. I went to Washington, D.C. for the first time, and best believe I vlogged the entire trip. So we're going to use that as my demo footage today. So let's, okay, I just have it back here. So I have all my clips already in a folder and it is sorted out. So I'm just going to go ahead and just click and drag it onto the timeline. And then it'll add it as a new scene as such. So I'm just going to go ahead and add in some clips just to start. And then we'll go in and like edit them and stuff. So just clicking and then dragging onto the timeline, and it's creating new scenes every time I drag a clip to this timeline. If you drag like a clip and put it on the canvas, it will put it on the current scene that you are selected in. So if you want to have an entire scene dedicated to a single clip, like have it separated out, make sure you're dragging it down to the bottom over here, and then it'll add a new scene. And so we're just going to zoom out to see all the clips. And then, yeah, so this is our timeline here at the very bottom. Okay, so now to reorder clips, all you have to do is just click and then just drag the clips in the order that you want. So this first scene, I was at a museum called Art Tech House in DC, and it's like a kind of like a digital art museum that blends technology and science and design all in one space. It was really cool. If you're ever in the area, definitely do it or visit it. Hi, Bree. Welcome to the stream. And it's really cool. I actually questioned like parts of my visit. Like, was any of this made in Adobe? Like, I have no idea. But that would be really cool if it did. Okay, so I'm just reordering some of these clips. And then to brace everyone's ears, because the last time I did a video demo, I blasted everyone's ears with the audio. I'm just going to go ahead and just click on each clip, and then we're just going to mute it. So this one's a time lapse, so no muting needed. I'm going to click on this. We're going to just going to mute all the clips because I'm not sure on the volume level on all of these. Gonna click here, just gonna mute everything, clicking on this, click mute, this, and mute. Okay, so now we are just going to scrub through the beginning. By the way, having creating a time lapse on a plane while it's taking off is really difficult. You gotta hold your hand steady for this, you know? And then here's the museum, the first shot. Okay, cool. And then, oh, this was like 2 seconds. Hold on. Okay, and then more stuff of me at the museum. Really cool. See, it's such a fun museum. Do any of y'all have any favorite museums that you like going to, or even types of museums? I definitely like art museums and science, for sure. Oh, and history too. Oh, okay. That's like everything. Okay, so let's get this clip. This will be like the opening shot. Now to trim clips, all you have to do is just click on or hover over the sides here, and then click and drag them in like this, and then it'll trim the clip for you. So we'll stop there, and then we'll trim this down. And then another way, if you want to split clips, all you have to do is just go on like the part that you want to split. You can either right click and hit split, or you can click the three dots, then hit split, or you, if you have a shortcut, depending on if you're on a PC or on a Mac, there's shortcuts. So mine is just S, so I just press S and then it splits. So, yeah. So that's how you trim and split the clips. So let's go ahead and just get the parts that I want. So I like to call this part, well, as if I invented it. No, so this part, what we're doing is we are basically doing the rough cut. So we're just going through all the raw clips and just like cutting the parts that we want to keep in the video. And it's still a bit like random. Like if I don't like how I pan this way, I can just cut it right before that. Oh, oops, made a mistake. Let's see. Bree on YouTube asks, can you edit more short form content? Can you edit YouTube videos? I would say you can edit full YouTube videos. For me personally, I do my short form stuff on here. But yeah, you can definitely edit YouTube videos on here if you wanted to. Let's see. Maybe I just want like this. This footage is a little, this one was taken directly from the Art Tech House app. It's a little choppy, but it's okay. It adds a different look to it. Why not? And then we have this one of me playing with stuff on the ground. I had a really interactive like projection on the floor. Okay, so this is where the most action happens. So I'm just going to include this. And then we can just get rid of this part. And then we have this clip. I'm running past these screens and it actually makes like sounds and stuff when you pass by. It's really cool. Do I need me running back? I don't think so. I think that's fine. We'll just cut it here. I've tried it once. The special video is kind of slow. Is it an internet issue or the navigator? It was on Safari. I'm not too sure, Daniel. I mainly use Adobe Express on Chrome, and from what I've heard, that it actually performs the best on a Chrome browser, but I don't know. I could be wrong. I do know that sometimes, like, if my video is extra long, the export will take a lot longer. And sometimes it might say it's failing. Or like it fails to export, but in that case, I would just refresh the tab and then usually it works. Okay, cool. So we have our clips here. So this is the first part. What are we at? We are at 37 seconds. Okay, so next I'm just going to add in a few more. Okay, so after this, I went to the Renwick. I'm just gonna keep adding clips here. So just clicking and dragging. Okay. So we have the clips from one Renwick, and then I'm going to rearrange this. There you go. And then same thing. I don't know the volume situation on these clips. So just to be safe, we are just going to mute everything, which is great because we are actually going to add in a voiceover as well as some music, some background music from Adobe Stock. So once that happens, there's this, we can get rid of this. Is it possible to have auto-generated captions within Adobe Express? It is not. Right now, Adobe Express does not do captions, but hopefully it does soon. That is a great suggestion because, yes, I love adding captions to all of my videos. So that would be amazing. I'm reading this. Can you add transitions? Oh, I did it wrong. Mute. Okay. Can you add transitions between clips? Right now you cannot add transitions between the scenes, but you can have the clips like loop in, like do an in enter and exit transition, but like a crossfade between clips, you can't do that quite yet. That makes sense. Some web applications work best with Chrome-based browser. Just don't know why. I don't know either, and I wish it was more consistent because I do create on both a PC as well as a Mac. So it would be amazing if apps had similar experiences across browsers. Okay, we need to mute this. I'm sorry for the volume. This was really cool. I was laying on the floor when I took this clip. I'll do that. And then I think this clip, I wanted it to be here. And yes, we're going to split that, delete that. I have been using the fade in, fade out animation on colored background for transitions. Yes, Valerie. Oh my gosh. That is a power tip. Pro tip from Valerie on YouTube to use fade in, fade out on a colored background. This one's cool. Okay, maybe we'll go up to there. Okay, and then last set of scenes. Food. We cannot forget about the food. One, I had dim sum, and then I went to Georgetown Cupcakes. Food. Okay. Cool. We are chilling off of clips. Also, if anyone has any tips or like anything to add about the video editor, feel free to drop them in the comments or in the chat box. Like I said, I feel like Adobe Express, like this beta version and video editing on Express is still very new. So if there's anything you've learned, any tips or tricks to make the workflow easier, feel free to share. What was I doing again? Oh, muting. Okay. Mute. Okay. So we have the dim sum, we have this. Okay, I kind of want this clip to start when the car is like mid rolling away. So we'll cut it there. And then also maybe I'll make this bigger for y'all to see. There you go. Okay, and then moving on to this one. This one's a closer shot. Okay, maybe I should back it up. Okay. Oh, it was raining. I totally forgot it was raining. Okay. We'll leave that in there. This is crazy. Y'all get to see like my filming style, that it's like super chaotic in the beginning and the end of each clip, and then I just stabilize it and then we're good. And by the way, if you were curious or if it wasn't obvious, this entire video was filmed on my iPhone 13 Pro. Oh man, I shook the camera. I really enjoyed the presets. Nice. Some of those render and use on Premiere After Effects, just like an asset library. Yes. If you add, Valerie asks, if you add your clips as scenes and then add graphics like titles, does it stretch across all scenes or only to the scene you drop it into? It's only in the scene that you drop it into. The only, so if you want like a piece of text to stretch across multiple scenes, you just have to copy and paste it into the next scene and then like adjust the timing there. The only assets that stretch across scenes is audio. Okay. Don't worry, we are on our last scene. Wow. Okay. It's a little long, so let's do this. I think going to Georgetown Cupcake was my highlight. I've watched the show since I was in high school, and I just loved the drama and the art of making cupcakes. But I was a big fan of the show. Okay, so we have all the clips here. This is the rough cut. And then the next thing that I actually like to do is put in the music. So the great part of Adobe Express is that along with the video and photo assets, there's actually audio assets as well that you can use. And they're really good for background musics, for vlogs. My favorite one to use is under the hip hop category. It just has like a good beat and stuff. It has like lo-fi and there's like vlog music in here, so I usually default to this first one, so just click on it, and then I am, as you can see, it stretches across the scenes, and so I am actually going to adjust the volume. Let's make it like a level 5 or something really low, because the audio clips are pretty loud, like a 3% to 5% is pretty good. So I've been stretching a single scene and dropping media instead of adding as a new scene because I can layer another video graphic without having to copy paste in all scenes. That's honestly, Valerie, that is a valid way of doing it as well. When I was like exploring scenes and stuff like that, like what was the best way? That was like my number one question too. Like which is better? Having one giant scene with like clips, like different video clips timed in each one, or doing different scenes. So I guess it's up to whatever works for you and what your editing style is, but honestly, I see nothing wrong with both ways. I think both ways are correct. So yeah. So if you're out there and you want to find a explore a different way of editing on Express, try that out. Okay, so we're just gonna duplicate this. And then I'm just gonna leave it here because I am going to cut up the clips even further. Okay. So now the reason why I do music is because I like to edit videos, like video clips to different beats. I don't know, it just kind of makes the vlog look a lot more put together. And, you know, the brain really likes when things fit together and make sense. So when clips change on beat, our brains really like that. we're just going to go ahead and retime the clips. So let's just play. See how loud that is? I mean, it's pretty medium coming through onto the stream, but in my ears right now, this is pretty loud for 3%. Anyways, let's just go ahead and recut this. Okay, so there's one on that beat. And then there's another beat. We'll cut it here. One feature, like wish list that I really want, is to be able to see the audio track just visually on here, because that's just my one wish list. My one wish list that I am manifesting is because visually, it's easier to edit to music when you can see like the wave forms, the sound waves. So you can see like the beats or any pauses in the music or anything like that. So you know like what to cut out. And it's not just for music, but also for like just audio tracks in general. Okay. Kind of just sit there. It's like around here. Okay. Oh my gosh, I'm giving like the auntie's stare, like when they're trying to work their iPhones, it's usually that that first shot, like what's going on? Okay. We have my friend playing with the screen. And then if it's choppy like that, don't worry too much. I personally don't worry too much if like footage looks choppy. It's the rendering. It just needs to a little bit of time to load. Okay. We'll cut this. And then I also like to play with different timings of different clips. So like if every clip was like on every other like downbeat, it gets a little repetitive. So sometimes I like to play with different lengths. Like I'll let some clips run longer or shorter, or even sometimes I'll even let clips switch off beat. Just add a little bit of chaos and keep people on their seat, you know? Let's see. FT on YouTube asks, what is the max res Adobe Express can handle? And please suggest how to upload an Instagram for high quality res. Thank you. For the max res, I'm not sure if anyone can chat or in chat can answer that question. I'm not exactly sure what the max resolution is for video. Like, what do you mean? Like the exporting? Because I know you can do 4K. If that's your question, I think that is your question. But yeah, you can do 720, 1080, and 4K. And then for uploading on Instagram for high quality res, there is an Instagram setting where it's somewhere in the settings that says like to upload in high quality resolution. And then also make sure the footage is also good quality. I would say my footage right now is very mid, so I'm probably gonna get a really mid resolution video. If I'm gonna be honest, a lot of this is shot in low light, and it's not exactly the best. Yes, for exporting. Yes. So yeah, 720, 1080, 4K. Okay, see? Oh my gosh. See, I love how this went on a different beat. I love it. Okay, cutting that. Now dim some. Okay, food's a little long. And cut it there. Cool, and then Georgetown cupcakes. Okay. Oh my gosh, it was raining. It was a hot rain too. I've never experienced hot rain before. I think we can cut there where the thing transitions. Okay, I actually hate how that clip is so long, so we'll do that, and then we'll cut this, and then we'll just skip to the ending where I pan over the cupcakes, because that's what people want to see. I'm gonna cut that, delete this. There you go. Cool. That's fine. That works for me. I wonder. Oh, you can't. Okay, I added another thing to the wish list, a fade in, fade out option. That would be great for music. Okay, anyways, moving on. So now we have the clips already timed to the music. Next, we can go work on the text. So when it comes to aesthetic vlogs, less is more. Less is definitely more, especially because no matter what platform you're posting to, whether if it's Reels, TikTok, or YouTube Shorts, there's a lot of overlays going on, you know, like Instagram has like the name at the top, everything has like the information on the bottom, and then the like, shares, comment, whatever on the side. It's just a lot to deal with, so really less is more, because you do not want your text to get cut off or distracting. Like, you just don't want the screen to be super cluttered. So I find that choosing a clean font, whether if it's your brand font or a sans serif font, going with that is the best way. And you don't want to have too much text on the screen, because people will just click away. Okay, so to add text, we're just going to go to the text tab, click add your text, and boom, we have a new text right here. And then all we're going to do is just click on, like, this is only day one of my DC trip, so we can do let's call it like the DC Diaries. Oh, how cute. And then we'll have a second one. We'll do a second text. Let's duplicate this. DC Diaries. You could put day one. Oh, how cute. Very cute. And then now we can just change the text just by clicking on the text that we want. And then we can change the font over here. I've been really loving doing like a little funky kind of text up top, and then like any subtitles or anything will be what's it called, sans serif, like just a regular font. So let's see what we have here. What are my recent fonts? What have I been doing? I don't remember doing this at all. This is actually the first time I'm opening Adobe Express like since coming back from vacation. This is cute. Oh my gosh, it's so funky. We like it. Maybe this one. This is nice. And then let's do white. And I usually default to white text because, I don't know, it's clean, I guess. And then this one's fine. Maybe we'll do all caps. And then another style that a lot of folks like to do to make something aesthetic is to adjust the line or letter spacing like this. And then make it a little bit smaller. Can I make this bold actually? Oh yes, there's a bold option. Nice. Something like this. So let's see what it looks like. Okay. So there we go. And then now let's add in some animation. Let's make it go in maybe like something like that. And then out. I don't think the out animation is as important than the in, but you can add one if you want. Oh, not text effects. Animation in. Let's also make this bungee, but can we make it go up? Yeah. Okay. So now we can There you go. So now it brings it in together. Okay, but let's say we wanted to adjust the timing of this. So if we wanted the one text to appear like earlier than the other, all you have to do is just click on the text that you want to adjust. And then same thing with the clips. You can trim the size just by clicking and dragging to where you want it to appear. So for example, there you go. See, it came in a little later. And because this timeline only highlights the current layer that you're working with, I like to leave the playhead of where like I last, where the last thing was. And then I'll just line it up with the playhead so that it is at the same time. Cool. So that's that. And then I'm just going to continue to add more text. So I'm just going to click on this. I think I can copy and then we can paste it here. Yes, we can. Okay. So now to be consistent with like the other text that I have, I'm just going to copy and paste the different text blocks. But these are going to mark the different locations. So like, for example, this was in our tech house, DC. And so I'm just going to put that here. Maybe make it smaller, drag it here. And then I'm going to add in a little icon. And then we're gonna maybe do like a location pin. Something like this. Ah, so cute. And then, can we adjust the fill? Yes, we can. And make the fill white. Let me zoom in a little bit for you guys so it's easier to see. So we can do something like this. Right, and then we can add in an animation. We can make it bungee down. And then for this animation can be maybe a pop or even a flicker. That seems cool. A spin. Oh my gosh, the tumble's chaotic. The tumble gets me. Maybe we'll do the flicker. Let's see what that looks like. So we're here. Okay, that's cool. Okay, so now we need to adjust the timing so we can make it do that. We could go down this way and then for this text. Okay, let's see what happens. Okay, so for the art tech house, okay, this is when the pin drops. And then for our tech house, I want it to come in here. Okay, so flicker is not working for me. So let's actually pick a different effect. So you drop. Drop seems fine. And then for this, maybe we can make it bungee out. This one can also fade out, right? Is it fade? What did I do? I can't remember. What was the in animation? Drop in. Okay, let's see how that looks. Okay, so we have this. Okay, so cool. We have what we need. So now I'm just going to take this location thing that I made. I'm going to group them together and then we're going to copy it and then we're going to go to the next location over here. We're going to just paste it in. No, I did it wrong. Wrong one. Oops. Didn't do it right. Copy. And then. And then we paste. There you go. And we're going to adjust this to say. Renwick Gallery. Cool. And then one more time. Did I do it right? Whoops. Let's bring it over here. Did I do it wrong? I think I did it completely wrong. Hold on. Oops. It didn't take the text. Whoops. Let's go back to this one. Oh, it's because it's grouped. Whoops. Yeah, I didn't. Oops. Oops. Oh no, I'm spiraling. Hold on. Okay. Dim sum. I cannot remember the place, so therefore, it is called Dim Sum for today. The timeline is not showing up. Let me just give it a quick refresh. I'm glitched. Okay, now we're back. Dim sum. Okay, and then we'll add it again here. Gonna copy this, then paste, change this. Oh man, I moved it. Georgetown cupcake, and that should be fine. I'll actually make this a little longer. Okay.
Cool.
All right, so that's pretty much the text and the animations. Everything looks good. Last thing we need to do is do the voiceover. Okay, so I found that Reels and TikToks do best, especially vlogs do best if there is a voiceover. Unless you're doing really cinematic stuff, I don't think a voiceover is needed. However, since this is a vlog, there's a bunch of different clips happening. We don't know what's going on. We're going to do a voiceover today. So we're just going to go click on the audio tab and you click on record voiceover and then make sure your mic is in. And then you just hit start recording. Okay. All right. Don't judge me. I'm not the best at voiceovers. Okay. Oh man, I moved. I know, right? Umicorn. Don't judge my voiceover abilities, okay? okay. I'm also thinking of this on the fly because I have not. Usually I'll write a script and read it, but I have not. So, I mean, also sometimes the best voiceovers are the ones that are unscripted and have mistakes in it. So, you know what? Teach their own. Okay, I'm just gonna go. Okay, we can edit it. Okay. 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 Come with me to Washington, D.C. for vacation. On the first day at D.C., I went to Art Tech House D.C., which is a digital art museum that blends design, science, and technology. And it was really fun. All the exhibits were interactive. And I went with one of my dearest friends that I met on YouTube about like 5 years ago. We had so much fun in this museum and the colors were beautiful. Okay, and then next I'm at the Renwick Gallery. You know, maybe I should like watch. I'm like, maybe I should watch the video first, but that's usually how my first take goes. Okay. All right, let's do it again. Oh man. Okay. Gosh, if the banhammer is going to get me for something, it's going to be this. For recording this voiceover. Okay. Come with me to DC for vacation. So on the first day in DC, I went to our Tech House DC, which is an art museum that blends design, science, and technology to create interactive exhibits, and I went with my friend and her husband, and oh gosh, I cannot do this unscripted. I did it again. Okay, last one. Come with me to DC on vacation. So the first day in DC, I went to Art Tech House DC, which is a digital art museum that blends science, technology, and design to create interactive exhibits. And it was so much fun. I met up with a friend that I've known on YouTube for almost 5 years. And it's just crazy to meet in person for the first time. And then I went to the Renwick Gallery, which is another modern art gallery, and they had a bunch of different exhibits, and it was really, really fun to see all the different art styles. And then for lunch, we went to dim sum, and then went to Georgetown Cupcake, because I'm a huge fan of the show, and we got some yummy cupcakes to end the day. It was awesome first day in DC. Best I could do. that's really the best I could do, but anyways. Volume. Let's see how the volume goes. Okay. Maybe we'll make this at like 10%. Dim sum, yeah, I know. The dim sum was so good. Yeah, that's how I record voiceovers. Usually there's a script and I get it on the first or second try, okay? But this is this is wild. Oh man.
Come with me to DC on vacation.
Okay. Sorry, I'm going through that complex of it's weird hearing your voice. Okay, so we can boost up this volume to maybe like 30, 40, 45.
Come with me to DC on vacation.
Oh God. All right, let's cut this. You can hear my breathing sounds.
Come with me to DC on vacation. So the first day I'm in DC.
Okay. You get it. First day I'm. Okay, I cannot listen to myself. I need to lower this down. It is loud in my ears.
So the first day I'm.
Okay. This is literally what video editing looks like all the time.
Come with me to DC on vacation.
Freestyling is difficult. It is very difficult.
So the first day I'm in DC, I went to our tech house.
So the first day in DC. You know, let's just.
The first day I'm in DC.
We're just going to go to I went to our tech house.
I went to our tech house.
It's going to be really rough.
I went to our tech house, DC, which is a digital art museum that blends science. I went to our tech house, DC, which is a digital art museum that blends science, technology, and design to create interactive exhibits. And it was so much fun. I met up with a friend that I've known on YouTube for almost 5 years. And it's just crazy to meet in person for the first time.
And you then can hear the panic in my voice.
Gallery, which is another modern.
Oh, I need to lower this one down to like 2.
The Renwick Gallery, which is another modern art gallery, and they had a bunch of different exhibits, and it was really, really fun to see all the different art styles.
Okay, this needs to be like a 1%. The vlog music is so loud.
I went to the Renwick Gallery, which is another modern art gallery, and they had a bunch of different exhibits, and it was really, really fun to see all the different art styles. And then for lunch, we went to dim sum and then went.
Okay.
Styles.
So we'll cut this and then.
And then for lunch, we went. And then.
There's a little bit of a pause here.
Art gallery, and they had a bunch of different exhibits. And it was really, really fun.
Wait! I'm cutting the vlog, like not the actual voiceover.
And it was really.
That was confusing.
And then.
You cut that.
And then for lunch, we went to dim sum and then went to Georgetown Cupcake because I'm a huge fan of the show and we got some yummy cupcakes to end the day. It was awesome first day in DC.
Cool. All right. So that's pretty much a really rough idea of what a with what an aesthetic vlog or on TikTok and Reels looks like. As you can see, it's really simple. Like keeping your text simple, the music, the clips are just like roughly cut, like back to back. And usually there's a voiceover, if it's not something like cinematic or is supposed to invoke like an ambiance. But yeah. we're just about at time. I hope you all liked this class and found it helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out back to me on social. I'm at Katrina Torrios on everything. But with that, thank you all so much for hanging out with me today. And I will see you all on my next class. All right. Bye. Have a good weekend, everyone.